Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube videos. In this video, I'm going to solve exercise 2.54 of the textbook First Course in Probability. So the goal of this problem is to find the probability that a bridge hand is void in at least one suit. I remind you that a bridge hand is a set of 13 cards chosen from an ordinary deck of 52 cards. And some interesting question that the author asks is, so the author is giving us a number like this, 4 choose 1 times 39 choose 13 divided by 52 choose 13, is also telling us that this is not the answer, and the first question is to answer why this is not the answer. So I'm going to start with this one. We are going to start by looking at this number, try to understand that number. It turns out that this is indeed a natural possible answer, but it's not in fact the actual answer. We are going to start to begin with to try to understand why this is not the answer, and from that, that's going to give us a hint to solve the problem. So first, let's call A the event of interest. So A is the event that the bridge hand is void in at least one suit. So bridge hand void in at least one suit. And then what we know from the book is that the probability of this event A is not equal to 4 choose 1 times 39 choose 13 divided by 52 choose 13. So why is that? So first we need to understand where this number comes from. So clearly in our deck of cards we have 4 suits, so it seems that this 4 choose 1 should be interpreted as the total number of ways you can choose one suit. Then after choosing this suit, if you exclude this suit from the deck of cards because we want to have our bridge hand void in at least one suit, then after removing this suit, there are 39 cards left, okay, 52 minus 13, and we choose just 13 cards from this set of 39. So the interpretation of this number is the number of ways you can choose one suit times the number of ways you can choose your bridge hand outside this suit, and you just divide by the total number of possible bridge hands. So it seems that this should give us the correct probability. However, that's not the case. So why is that? Well, the reason why we don't have a correct estimate of the probability, in fact, this number is going to slightly overestimate the probability that the bridge hand is void in at least one suit, is because of those type of bridge hands. So here I prepare a bridge hand where you have only spades and hearts. You don't have any clubs or diamonds. So this bridge hand is void not in one suit, but two suits. So void in clubs and diamond. So if we go back here, you may at the first step choose diamond, okay? You want your bridge hands to be void in diamonds, and you multiply by this. This number is going to count the bridge hands I just showed you. However, you can also, instead of diamonds, choose clubs at the first step, and then choose a bridge hand that is void in clubs. Okay? So that means that this type of bridge hands, okay, void in two suits, okay, diamonds and clubs, is in fact in this expression here counted twice. Okay, so that's the point. The point is that we count this expression is going to double count bridge hands that are void in more than one suit. So now this tells us more or less that being void in a given suit does not exclude the fact that you can be void in another suit. And so that means that, again, the event that you are void in diamonds does is the event that you are void in diamonds and the event that you are void in clocks are not mutually exclusive events. And so this expression would be correct if indeed you cannot be void in more than one suit when you deal with four events, one for each suit, that are mutually exclusive, but it turns out that those events are not mutually exclusive. So what do we do in this case? Well, we cannot use, like here, additivity of a probability. We have to use the inclusion-exclusion identity. So that's what we are going to do. Now, this term is going to be the first term in the expression we find from the inclusion-exclusion identity, but we need to add some correction to that, looking at bridge hands that are void in two or three suits. So, to solve the problem, something natural is to express this event A as a union of four events, corresponding to all four suits being void in a given suit. So I'm going to introduce the event AI. We are going to have four of them. That's the event that the bridge hand is void in exactly, I mean, in a specific suit I, okay? Then this is well defined for I equals 1, 2, 3, 4. We just number our suits 1, 2, 3, 4. We introduce those events. And then clearly A is the event A1 union A2 union A3 union A4. The number that I just erased given by the author is exactly the probability of A1 plus the probability of A2 plus the probability of A3 plus the probability of A4. That's not the probability of the union because those events are not mutually exclusive. So to solve the problem, we just start by writing that P of A is equal to the probability of the union of the four events, A1 union, A2 union, A3 union, A4. Then the inclusion-exclusion identity tells us that this is equal to the sum of the probabilities minus the sum of the probabilities of intersection of any two events plus sum over all possible choices of three of those events of the probability of intersection of all three and so on. So basically, we know that this should be equal to P of A1 plus P of A2 plus P of A3 plus P of A4. Then we need to correct this term by removing the probability of intersection of any two events, so A1 intersection A2 minus probability of A1 intersection A3 and so on. I'm not going to write everything, that's too many terms, minus the probability of, let's say, the last one in lexicographic order would be S3 intersection F4. Okay? Then, now, this expression is going to underestimate this probability. We need to add the probabilities of intersection of three events, so plus P of A1 intersection A2 intersection A3. And so on. Then we end up with probability of A2 intersection A3 intersection A4. And then finally we need minus from, like in general, what the inclusion-exclusion identity tells you, you need a minus probability of intersection of all four events, so A1 intersection A2 intersection S3, intersection S4. Okay, so now it turns out that the probability of any of those events, like all those probabilities here, are much easier to compute than the probability of the union. Typically, intersection of events define new events that are more natural to understand. Now, it's still a mess here. You have a lot of terms. It turns out that in fact we don't need all those terms. So first observation, let's look at this event here, A1 intersection A2 intersection A3 intersection A4. That's exactly the event that you are void in all four suits. Obviously this event is empty. If you take 13 cards or even just one from a deck of 52 cards, then you must have at least one suit. So that means that this term in fact is equal to zero. It appears in the inclusion-exclusion identity, but you don't, in this particular case, you don't need it. It's equal to zero. So I'm going to remove that. That's the first simplification. Second simplification, well, if you look at all those events, like those four events, well, they must have the same probability. Being void in hearts, or being void in diamonds, or being void in spades, or being void in clubs, are four events with exactly the same probability, because you have exactly the same number of each of the suits in an ordinary deck of 52 cards. So by symmetry, those four events have the same probability. Same story here. If you look at any two of those events, the probability of the intersection should not depend on the particular two events you chose. Being void in hearts and diamond has the same probability of being void in spades and clubs, for instance. So that means that, again, all the terms on this line have the same probability. All the terms on this line are equal. And again, same thing here. So using some symmetry like this, the fact that we have perfect symmetry in all four suits implies that in fact, we can simplify this expression and just say that, well, that's P of A1 times 4, and then P of A1 intersection A2 times whatever number we need that here, and so on. So now, next step is to count the number of events we have each time. So here we have indeed 4, okay? It's like choosing one suit out of 4. That's a 4 choose 1. And here, the number of terms we are going to have that involve two suits is exactly 4 choose 2. If you look carefully at this line here, that's going to correspond to a minus P of AI intersection AJ, where basically I and J are all possible choices of two suits out of four suits. So that gives you 4 choose 2 terms. And here you are going to have 4 choose 3 terms. Using this, you can simplify your expression. So I'm going to erase all that and write all this in some much more compact form using the symmetry. So now we know that this is equal to 4 choose 1 times the probability of any of those events. Let's take A1, okay? Minus 4 choose 2, number of ways you can choose two suits out of 4, then times probability of intersection of any two of those 4 events. Let's take the first two ones, A1 intersection A2, and then we still need a plus 4 choose 3 times probability of intersection of 3 events. Let's take A1 intersection of 2 A3. Okay, so that gives us our simplification here. Then last step is to indeed compute those terms. But now things are easier. Here it's being void in suit 1. That doesn't exclude the fact that you can be void in other suits. So those events are much more friendly than this event here. And so eventually you conclude that. So this is equal to your 4 choose 1. Then number of ways you can choose, your bridge hand in such a way that the bridge hand is void in suit 1 and can be void in other suits is exactly the number of ways you can choose 13 cards from a set of 39, That means that you look at all the cards that are not in this suit here, in suit 1. So here you have your 39, choose 13. And of course you need to divide that by the total number of great hands to have your probability, so that's 52, choose 13. You recognize the term we had, we looked at the beginning, okay? That's not the answer. The answer is in fact this, but you have some correction after looking at intersection of two or three events. Then second term here is going to be of the form, so 4, choose 2. You want to look at the number of ways you can choose 13 cards, but those 13 cards cannot be in suit 1 or 2. What you have left is a set of 26 cards to choose from. So here you have to multiply by 26, choose 13. Again, you divide by 52, choose 13. And then last step, plus a 4, choose 3, times the number of ways you can choose 13 cards that are not in suit 1, 2, or 3. That means that all the 13 cards must be in suit 4. You have only 13 such cards, so you have only one way to do this, and that gives you in fact a 13, choose 13. 13 choose 13 is equal to 1. And then you again have to divide this by 52 choose 13. So that's the correct answer. Eventually, you see that the leading term, that's also the largest term of the three, is this answer given by the author, which is not correct. And now we understand why. It's because we need a correction looking at intersection of two or three events, because those four events here are not mutually exclusive. So eventually you get this answer for the probability that a bridge hand is void in at least one suit. If you use a calculator to compute this explicitly, you would find that the probability that a bridge hand is void in at least one suit is about equal to 0.05126.